Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In last video, we learned how to download and install Microsoft SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio. In today's video, we will learn how to interact with the SQL Server Management Studio and some basic steps like how to create database, schema and tables. So here on the screen, you can see when we install Microsoft SQL Server on a system, it creates an instance for us. That is a very high level container. Under that, all the services and objects will run. We have databases. You can assume it's a container within the instance container where we have all the databases. Further in databases, we have schema, that is a logical container of the database objects. Under that, we have tables like tables, views that we are going to learn how to create and use in this series. In below screenshot, you can see in the last video, we installed SQL Server database instance on our system. So here you can see the desktop NEABU BVU2 is the SQL Server instance installed on this system. After that, we have databases, that is called My Database. Under My Database, we have schema called DBO. DBO is the default database schema created by SQL Server. If we are not going to create any new schema, or if we are not providing the schema name along with the object while create, the object will create within the default schema, that is DBO. And next to this, we have table name. From this image, you can understand how the containerization happens in SQL Server. Now let's jump into the SQL Server Management Studio and see how this works in real life. Now we are on SQL Server Management Studio login screen. Here you can see by default, the username SA is given. This is the default user created by SQL Server to log in into instance. If you want to avoid to use this user, then we can create our own user that we will cover in future videos. So let's connect to this instance. Now here you can see on the left side, we have Object Explorer where we have instance name. Under that, we have all the objects. On the top ribbon, you can see there are various menus to interact with the SQL servers. So here we have new query. Let me click on that. And this is our new query window from where we can execute queries on SQL Server database. While we are in a query window on top, you can see there is another toolbar has been opened. Let's go through that menu bar. The first button is for connection. If you want to reconnect to the instance with some different credentials, here we get list of all the databases available in this connected instance. So here you can see there is a master, model, MSDB and TempDB database. These are the system databases created by SQL Server for different purposes. After that, we have execute buttons. If we want to execute any command on SQL Server, then we have to type it in a query window. Then we have to press execute button, or there is a shortcut F5. All the rest of buttons we will go through later while we will use the command where these buttons is required. So now let's start with executing some commands on the SQL Server. Now let's try to create one database. So for that, the command is create database. Then we have to provide database name. For now, let me provide the database name as a DB, then database name test. And let's press F5 to execute this command. In bottom window under messages, we can see the command has completed successfully. Now let's go to Object Explorer again and refresh the list of objects and expand this. We should see our database. Yep, here we have our database db_test that we have just created. Now in the top menu, you can see our databases, DB databases available here now. So we can select DB test database. Now from this point, if we execute any command, that command will execute on DB test database. But now for now, let me select master database again. And let's try to select the database, that is db_test that we have created from the command line itself. So for that, the command is use db_test. That is our database. Let's press F1. Now here you can see the DB test database has been selected. Now from this point, whatever command we will execute, that will execute within DB test database. From here you can imagine we have landed within the DB test database container. Now under DB test container, let's try to create one schema. And for that, the command is create schema. And we have to provide a schema name. Let me give it schema underscore test. Now execute command. Command has executed successfully and our schema has created. Now we know under schema we can create objects. So let me create one object, that is table. So for that, the command is create table, then table name. So let me provide table name as a TBL, that is short form of the table underscore test. And for table, we must need to provide list of columns that we want to create within table. So I know we have not covered table till now, but for now, just consider we are creating table object. So let me provide one column name, let's say ID as integer. And since we are trying to create this table within the schema that we just have created, so we need to provide the schema name dot table name. So let's press F5 now. Here our command is completed and we should have table in our database. So let's refresh the object explorer again and expand our database. Under database we have tables. Under tables we have schema underscore test schema dot tbl test, that is our table. And under table we have one column that is called ID. So in this way we have created one database. Under that we have created schema. Under schema we have created table. And under table we have one column called ID. Now let's try to clean up all these test objects that we have created just now. For that the command is drop. So let's type drop and object name. Let's drop table first, then object drop table, and the object name is schema underscore test dot tbl underscore test. Press F5. Command completed successfully. Now let me refresh this and table gone. Now since we have dropped only table, now let's try to drop schema as well. For that I need to remove table name, and instead of dropping table I need to provide drop schema, then schema name. Let's hit F5 and here you can see command has completed successfully. That means schema has gone. Now above schema we know the next level or high level container is the database. So now let's try to drop the database. For that the command is drop database and then database name. Before dropping database we have to think what would be required to drop database. So here we have database and currently we are logged into the same database DB test. Now I am trying to drop the same database where I am logged in. So definitely it will create a problem because there is a live session going on, and how I can drop an object where some process is happening right now. So let's try to drop this database while we are using this. Let me press F5 and here we got message that cannot drop database because it is currently in use. That is expected. So let me change the database from DB test to some other database, or let me write the command use master. Right now here the database has got changed. Now let me try to drop the test database. So I have selected that and now let's execute this command and here we go. The database has been dropped successfully. To summarize that, today we have learned how the SQL Server container works, how under instance we have databases, under database and we have schema, under schema we have different objects like tables, views and etc. Also we tried to create database, schema, table, and then we dropped all the databases. Try to practice it, and if you find any issue then post it in a comments and I will try to answer you wherever you are stuck. If you want me to elaborate any command that we covered today, then please let me know in comments. I will try to cover that. Till then, take care. Bye.